mom was gravely ill 2 years back, and when she was in the hospital one night, she was very high on morphine and she started to hallucinate, and she kept calling me out and saying, quickly, quickly, we need to grab our bags and go into the coach, and do remember to take the magical things under the bed. Until the third day after her funeral, and I was resting on her bed at home, and on her side, and one Sunday morning I just saw, I decided I should peek under and take a look, and you know, lo and behold, underneath it was actually this really old retro looking heart suitcase. So I tried very hard to open it, I couldn't, and until a few days later my dad managed to pry it open, and what was unraveled was actually a bunch of his paintings that we knew existed. Letting you discover, and sometimes he just watch, you know, as a child, then you know, he watches intently to observe where he can find teachable moments.
He's a Nanyang style artist. He once told me, "Northern people crossed over, came here, lived here, accepted here, seasons are sunshine." 他们是搞艺术，所以他们在这里受到这里的环境变迁各方面，所以他们的绘画就产生很多的颜色。 我跟 沈光德老师是在我读 南艺的时候， 1982年的时候， 然后老师就说，下半年就会轮到你上我的课了，就是这样，我们就等哦。可是等不及就整天会跑进他班上，所以他已经认得我了嘛。Fern,
whom I would always call her Mingying Jie, is one of the youngest art students when my grandfather was still alive. So she was coming to the house for lessons very often, and I remember her being very close to her teacher, maybe like about the last 10 years or so.
Ian 看见我来这里，他会，嘿，他就出来，他在这里，嘿，然后就跟我笑，然后我们就拉着我就进去了，就坐在那边，拿一张纸，记得拿一张纸，不然就折，不然就剪。
So that's how our relationship was like when I was younger. So we lost touch for a good amount of time. Until this year, when we got reconnected again over the New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. He literally knew every other Chinese instrument, right down from the guzhen, pipa, the xiao, and also even the erhu.
He liked to play the dong xiao. He not only played the 自己在修改过他的那个动的位置，来配合他自己的手指头和音质。音乐也会，雕刻也会，制造乐器也会。所以我就觉得这老师很有趣哦。最怀念就是他很细心的教我裱画，然后因为他教会了我裱画。
后来我从那个时期起，我就开始以裱画作为我的那个工作。那时候我的工作不是很顺，所以他就会给我带一点东西回去。我就笑了，我说老师，你这样给我带回去，是不是要给我妈妈知道我？ 今天有东西可以带回去，因为我们的收入很少，他就会他说不要哭，他说眼泪不可以随便的流下来，他说有什么东西可以画画，可以做手工，可以让你从最伤心、最寂寞、最气愤的时候，他说艺术可以熏陶你。所以他说永远如果你在很寂寞的时候，你会知道你学艺术哦是不会寂寞的。
他很细心的叫跟我们讲，就是不要看清有钱人，不要看清那些学得慢的人。沈观泽老师来华中之后，他就发现很多穷学生，那么他就用了那个龟壳教我们如何把它锯出来，然后加上一个锁匙链，然后做成锁匙圈，然后拿去卖了。所以对我们学生来讲帮助很大，我们可以有这个多余的钱来付学费啊，或者是那个买书的钱。
Somehow it felt like the family or the community of students, they're all just like coming together. So it's wonderful, you know, to see how many lives he's actually impacted as a gentle, quiet man.
人家就说我做事情太老实，可能跟我的个性有关系。我是要实实在在这样子。
这个老人哦，真的是我很怀念的一个人，很窝心，像一个慈父，就是这样，话不多，但是如果他现在在，我还是一样会回到这个地方，多忙多累我都很想看看他，真的
是我自己喜欢这样画我就画，假如为艺术而艺术呢，看起来比较有价值一点。